Oh, 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 hey. Oh, 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 hey, yeah. Oh, oh, yeah.
Blessed be the name of the Lord, and let's give Jesus a round of applause. And let's give him the glory now.
You cannot praise God as if you are dead. You cannot praise God as if you are dead. Revival. But open your heart. Get ready to receive the word of God. Hallelujah. But what about Mutimu? What that you can rattle the carlo? Come on, Kanga Mutima, I am a mona. Baba ready. Tell me what you are in the valley. Wouldn't turn a hate. Give me a weed swan. And I get a weed swan. It ain't finish. So get ready. Open your heart and receive the word of God. Amen. Hallelujah. Back rest. Lele khono lena mathaba mengana re tlhompile ke modimo ka motlhanga wa hae ha ke motsebe fela ke motseba ga botse le mo atswang hona ke tseba le kereking ya hae ke tseba le lelapa la hae. Man of God, hi, a re shapele morena Jesu matsogo.
Jesus.
Muruti rametse go tswa midrand e tla bolela se modimo a se beileng pelong ya gago. Jole ke re, get ready, open your heart and receive the word of God.
Jesus,
arba shapele matso.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. You may be seated. We greet you all in the name of Jesus. Amen. Let me tell you something. I am so humbled to stand here. Thank you very much to the parents of the house. I humble myself before you. It's a blessing. It's an honor to be here. Some of the things, it is by God's order.
Amen.
Not by human's hands. Last year after I was here, how I knew that this church is very famous is that I got calls and SMS and everyone, but we want to go to that place where you were. Now that's why at the All Night Prayer, some of people who wanted to be under this anointing were there.
They are
people from far who want to be here. So it's amazing if you come from near but you don't want to be here. There is something special about your parents. God gave them the jump, the cue kind of anointing. Some people, to do what they are doing today, it takes them a lifetime. Some people, they want to do it but it's just not happening. No, I'm telling you the truth. When you see, grace is when the work is growing and multiplying and things are happening. I'm saying you are blessed to be part of God at work ministry. God has called you for great things. I want us to go to the scriptures. I want us to read from chapter 2, 2 Kings chapter 2, verse 19. Then the men of the city said to Elisha, please notice the situation of the city is pleasant, as my Lord sees, but the water is bad and the ground is barren. And he said, bring me a new bowl and put salt in it. So they brought it to him. Then he went out to the source of the water and cast in the salt there and said, thus says the Lord, I have healed this water, from it there shall be no more death and barrenness. Hallelujah. The Lord has put this message in my heart. And I've watched your pamphlets. They are written something very beautiful. Breaking the barriers and limitations. Where we read tonight, the people and the men of the village were with
Elisha.
Now Elisha was after he received double portion of anointing. Because that was after Elijah have went to heaven. They believed that this man has just received double portion of anointing. And by the reason of anointing upon his life, this situation will change when we tell him. I want to start talking to us today that situations do change. It doesn't matter how long the situation has been. It doesn't matter whether people have already accepted. But it will take the men who are tired of the situation and say it might look normal, but it is not pleasant. How many things that we are going through, they look normal, they are accepted, but they are not nice. The men of the city realize that is about time we take them to the Lord, and we believe that as long as the Lord is
Jehovah,
this too must change. Situation do not change just because they are old. Situation do not change just because they are believers around. Situation changes when you start to be fed up, when you refuse to understand, when you say enough is enough, this must change. Now the Bible says the water of the area, it was salty. Therefore, it was causing barrenness. No one will have a child. And all the plants that grow in the area, people who eat them, they will get sick and die. And I will tell you today, there is so much barrenness in our life. There is so much anti-progress spirit in our life. Because we have accepted. We think that is how things should be. Things can turn around. Things can be different. Let me tell you something. Water
metsi.
Is known as a source of life. Water
metsi.
Is life itself.
Ke bophelo ka bona.
But that thing which was supposed to give life was bringing death, was bringing pain, was terminating life. Things can turn around in families. I will tell you something. Some marriages, we go there and then we bless them and we say happily ever after, because marriage is supposed to be a situation of joy. But guess what? There are people who are crying day in and day out. When you ask why, it's because of the very same marriage. Until you stand up and say, Lord, I bring the situation to you. Bring my joy back. Bring my peace back. This is not how it's supposed to be. Sometimes we receive children, bless them and dedicate them. But as time goes, you realize that not even a single blessing have landed upon this child. This thing is like a small devil. And the community start to say, this is how children of these days are. I am saying to you tonight, don't agree to the report of the devil. Believe the report of the Lord. The report of the Lord. Say you are free. And even this child, we will redeem him with the blood of Jesus. He will come back. He will be alive. He will turn around. And he will be fruitful. Sometimes normal things are not as normal as we think. Things must change. Things must change. I want to tell you something. I know the kind of salvation wherein young boys and young girls, they cannot sleep together without marriage. But I'm telling you, that kind of the gospel has tend to be an endangered species. We don't even talk about it. But I want to speak to young people who are filled with the power of the Holy Spirit. I say you can still redeem yourself. Paul says, I speak to you young people, because you have defeated the evil one. You can rise up and say, this is not normal. Everybody has accepted, but I refuse. I say, not in my name. It's not going to happen. I'm not going to participate. I will stand for the truth and the word. It might look normal, but I will tell you the truth tonight. It can change. The Bible says, Elijah took the salt. The water's problem was the salt. And he threw the salt into the salty water and declared change. And the water changed. And the word of God in the book of Matthew chapter 5, it says, you the salt of this world. And if the world can
can receive your seasoning, the world will change. I want to talk to you tonight. You are that kind of the salt that is supposed to change the barrenness of your situation, the barrenness of the community. Breakthrough will come in your name. Breakthrough will come because of the salt that is you. Now let me tell you something about limitations. Limitation is, let's say you are an educator. You're teaching children. And you are taking this one learner, you put her at the back. And when you busy writing, this child does not write. When you look at this child, you will think something is wrong. The child is not obedient. Why is the child not participating? Now, if you understand that there are barriers that can stop other kids to participate, then you will get close to that child and ask the child, why are you not participating? And you will find out a barrier. And you find that the child cannot write because the child cannot see. Then you take the child. You bring the child to the forth. And then now the child start to write. And I believe this is how Jesus is intending to change your barriers, to break your limitations. The Bible says he took a step that he go to the cross so that he can draw you near. Because when you are far, you can't see his love, you can't see his power, you can't see his generosity, you don't understand anything. But when he brings you closer, your eyes will open, your barriers are broken in the name of Jesus, and you start to realize that you cannot be troubled by a taste of a salt, because you yourself are the salt. Not just the salt, but the salt of the world, the salt that will turn things around. You are not called for small things. You are called for the world. You are not called to influence a few, but you are called to influence the world. When Jesus position you, you will never cry again. Let's take to our feet and raise up our hands. A taste of salt can do nothing to the salt itself. You are something powerful, more powerful than your situation. When you say a word, things turn around. When you say a word, all that is lost will come back. When you save
by faith. Things that are not will become. There is power in you. There is power in you. I want us to pray. Let's say, Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for bringing us closer so that you can break our barriers and our limitation. In your name, Jesus, we will rise above the pain, we'll rise above the sicknesses, we will rise above poverty, we will rise above sadness. We thank you, Jesus, for your love. Thank you for your blood. Thank you for your wounds. We bless you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Let's clap hands for Jesus. Let's clap hands for Jesus. Let's clap hands for Jesus. He is worthy to be praised. He is the beginning and he is the end. There is no other name in heaven above and even on earth that should be praised. Only the name of Jesus should be lifted high. Jesus, we enthrone you tonight. Take all the glory. Take all the glory, Jehovah. We bless